Hey guys, Todd Durgan here, lead training advisor for Under Armour and the designer of this Wounded Warrior Project 8K training manual and this guide in this workout C, the third workout strength circuit. Overall, we're gonna provide three different circuits within workout C for you to get great results for your 8K training and event. So let's get after it right here. First exercise, we have dumbbell incline dumbbell bench press. So what we're gonna have, choose a light weight in the beginning, especially if you're not lifting a lot of weights right now on this. Choose the weight, the incline should be about 30 to 40 degrees on this. This is gonna work more of your upper chest. All of this is gonna incorporate lower body, core, and upper body with all of the different exercises. But the incline dumbbell bench press is certainly going to work your upper body and complete for the desired sets and reps. This is circuit style, so once you're done with that, minimize your rest time. Put the weights on down into the jump complex. We're now getting strong and more powerful. We're gonna go vertical jump and broad jumps. So you're gonna do that for your complete, let's say three, and then broad jumps. Now you're going forward. What I like about this movement right here is you're going in one plane up, and then you're gonna move forward, coming on forward two or three, whatever it takes. Awesome job right there. So great for the legs. If you're working your lunges and your squats and your dumbbell, your goblet squats, things that are in workouts A and B, those different movements you can check out over at the YouTube for workout A and B. These are great ways to supplement that and add to the diversity. Next up, we got a single dumbbell clean and press. Now I like the single side because anytime you do a unilateral, you can compare sides and see if one side's different than the other. So here you take your dumbbell, start light, you can always get heavier, and for your desired sets and reps, you're gonna just explode with your hips up toward your shoulders. Once you seat it at your shoulders, you're gonna add your press. If you have any shoulder issues and you can't press, then you can certainly just seat it at your shoulder on that. This is a hip and lower body dominant exercise, and of course you're gonna add some shoulders as well. Complete those three exercises between your incline dumbbell bench press, your jump complex, and your single arm dumbbell clean and press for desired sets and reps. Good job, Jesse, right there, he's getting after. Next, choose the light dumbbells, okay? And you have your dumbbell eyes, Ys, and Ts. Eyes, Ys, and Ts. We're now on the second circuit. Again, with all of these, minimize rest time. Between your circuits, if you want to take a minute or even two off, feel free. But I want this workout C to be done within 45 minutes with your dynamic warm-up, with your Super 7 joint integrity exercise, which precede this right here. So let's rock and roll, okay? So eyes, okay, hands go out forward, and then Ys, okay, and then Ts. Let's do a few eyes in a row, please, Jesse, so they can see it. Okay, the eyes right here out in front, like you're doing an eye, right? Once you get your desired eyes, then you go Ys, okay? So you're gonna go out wider. This is great for the backside shoulder, the rotator cuff, your external rotators, and all your posterior deltoid, backside shoulder. And then Ts coming up next. Awesome job. Dumbbell, eyes, Ys, and Ts. Awesome job right there, Jesse. Take your little rest, drop one, you have your single leg, okay? RDLs, single leg RDLs, Romanian deadlifts, workouts A and B, had a lot of RDLs as well. Continue, on one foot is down, your core is strong, and you got your opposite arm and leg, okay? So his right foot's down, and the left arm is holding the dumbbell. If you can please turn sideways, continue that same motion so they can see from the side, okay? Now he's got his left foot down, dumbbells in the right side. Notice the nice flat back with that single leg RDL. This is working core, it's working the backside hip, and that is fantastic right there, Jesse. Last one, the third exercise in circuit two, dumbbell rainbows. Okay, so with the rainbows right here, Jesse will demonstrate all the way around. What does this work? Okay, it works core, it works shoulders. Okay, so he's just trying to get some rotational movement so we're not always linear runners, right? So this is good. Notice his feet are cemented into the ground here. His core, hips are nice and stable. He's coming all the way around with the dumbbell rainbows. That completes the circuit number two of that right there. Complete those, eyes, Ys, and Ts, your single leg dumbbell RDLs, and your rainbows. Take your minute off if you need it. If you don't need it after you get through all those desired sets and reps, simply so you can see, get your other dumbbell, and you have more RDLs. I'm after your legs. I'm after those legs. Let's start up. You can go two-legged RDLs. I love two-legged, basic, simple. Okay, let's turn it face sideways, please, so they see the hip hinge movement. This is a hip hinge movement. The back is nice and flat. Pause. That's a flat back, my friends. I want to see a flat back. The booty is sticking back. He feels that in his hamstrings, his glutes, and it's a great lower back strengthener. This is a great start position and standing nice and tall. This right here is a dumbbell RDL. Good, continue that a few more reps so they can see that. Awesome. Pause at the last one, into your rows. You got dumbbell rows now. It's two dumbbells, pinching back side. Awesome. Good. And relax. And the final third exercise in this third circuit is your dumbbell push press. Okay, with the push press, I want to see some movement from the hips. Okay, so it's explosive action. It's a hip and lower body as well as a shoulder as well. So in workout C, you've got some explosive movements between the jump complex, between your dumbbell push press. You have some explosive lower body and upper body movements. You have upper body strength and lower body strength as well. Take a look at your Wounded Warrior Project WWP 8K training guidelines for, depending on what week you're on, 1 through 10, for your desired reps and sets. If you do workouts A, B, and C, all of them have 3 strength training circuits, and you do your dynamic warm-up for 5 to 10 minutes, your super 7, no more than 7 minutes, and you do these circuits, which are going to take you about 20 minutes, give or take, you're going to be wrapped up, ready to hit your core, get your stretch, and out of the gym within 45 minutes. Jesse, great job in workout C. Let's continue with our core blast for the WWP 8K training event right now.